Hey, SEC family. Thank you for joining me today for another devotion. Today, I want to talk about grace. Romans 12:2 says, don't copy the behavior and customs of this world, but let God transform you into a new person by changing the way you think. God wants to change the way we think, a renewed mind. God changed the way we think so that we can see things the way He sees them. That's having a renewed mind. The more I can see something as God sees it, the more it changes the way I think. If I could see this world the way God sees it, really see it the way that God sees it, wouldn't I have a little more compassion for people? I've often thought, if I could just see my sins as God sees them, really see them as God sees them, it would change me. I would see how it hurts me. I would see how it hurts others. I would see the eventual results of my sin. The truth is, when you come to Christ, He gives you a new life. The more I can see the fact that He's given me this new life and live that new life, the more real it becomes. Becoming renewed in the spirit of your mind. It all happens by grace. It starts by grace, and it ends by grace. Galatians chapter 3, verse 3 says, how foolish can you be after starting your Christian lives in the Spirit? Why are you now trying to become perfect by your own human effort? It's all grace all the way through. A renewed mind is not just determination. It's determined dependence on God. There's a big difference between those two. The power is in His grace. You live the Christian life the same way you started the Christian life. You started it by grace, and you live it by grace. I know some people who aren't believers yet who say, well, you know, I'd like to become a Christian, Jerry, but I mean, I'm considering what it means to be a believer in Christ, but truthfully, I don't know if I can keep all the rules. What I'm saying to you today is the Christian life is not a life of rules. The Christian life is a life of a new power. It's a new and different way of thinking. You're living a new way because you have a new power in your life. Maybe you've met someone who've been living the Christian life by rules or by doing good or by feeling bad. But that's not what the Bible teaches us about true Christianity. Real faith in Christ is built on God's grace. The question that comes up is, well, then where do I start in this whole thing of growth? It really comes down to one word, trust. Am I going to trust God or not? You start with trust. You start by believing in God's ability to accomplish this growth goal in your life. The motivational power for growth isn't found from within you. It's found within Him. The motivational power is this. God wants and is willing and is working for us to grow every day of our life. The minute I come to Him and I give Him my life, He says, I'm going to start working on making you grow. Growth is not accomplished by trying harder. It's accomplished by trusting Him more. Philippians 1:6 says, God, who began the good work within you, will continue His work until it is finished on the day when Christ returns. And in chapter 2, verse 13 of Philippians, it says, for God is working in you, giving you the power, giving you the desire and the power to do what pleases Him. I love that promise. Not only does He help me want to do the right thing, He helps me do the right thing. God's never going to give up on helping us do the right thing. That's what grace is all about. He's more committed to our growth than we are. That's what grace is all about. Listen, I love you as your pastor. I'm going to be praying for you today. I hope you have a fantastic day today and a great week. God bless.